Okay, in this example, I'm going to show you how we will program the same things that we put into the GP380 but into a GP340. So let me start with the GP340 code plug. So this is the default factory code plug which is installed with the CPS. And I'm going to start by specifying the encoders and the decoders. Now, for the GP340, remember we don't have a display. So we cannot use variable digits. But we can do is we can still make selective calls. But this will only be able to be done to a fixed number. Okay. So, let's think about what we need to put into this radio. We need a sequence for PTT-ID. We need a sequence for selective call to call the other radio. We need a sequence to identify this radio to the other radio. We need a sequence to send when the radio goes into emergency mode. We need a sequence to send an AUTAC knowledge when the radio receives stun and unstun. Right, let's have a look. So this radio's ID will be 01002. So 01 means PTT-ID on our code plan, and 0002 is the number of this radio. Sequence 2 will be used to call the other radio. So in this case, it can be 02001. Remember, 0001 was that number of the GP380. Sequence 3 will be to identify this radio when it makes a selective call. So it will be 02002. Then sequence 4 will be the sequence the radio sends when it's in emergency. So it will be 03002. Then sequence 5 will be the AUTAC knowledge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Digits, 6 zeros. Let's tie these together by means of the telegram. So in this case, we, like before, we need 4 telegrams. Telegram 1 will send sequence 1. Telegram 2 will send sequence 2 and sequence 3. Telegram 3 will send sequence 4. And telegram 4 will send sequence 5. In terms of AUTAC knowledge, when we send a PTT-ID, we don't need an acknowledge. But when we send a selective call, we expect an acknowledgement. Okay, for the others, no acknowledge expected. Let's look at the decoders. Again, I need 7 decoders. Whoops, 7. Decoder number 1. Well, do we actually need 7 decoders? Because this radio will not decode and display PTT-ID. So, only need 6 decoders. Let's look at decoder number 1. Decoder 1 we use to decode selective call. Now, this radio doesn't have a display, so it can't display the calling radio's ID, but it can still be alerted. Remember, when the other radio is calling this radio, it's going to send 2 sequences. The first sequence will be the ID of this radio. The second sequence will be the ID of the radio which is calling it. So really, this radio doesn't need the second sequence. All we need to do is put in 02002. So when this radio receives 02002, it will sound an alert. It will start the auto reset timer, and it will send an auto acknowledge. Decoder 2. Decoder 2 will be used to decode the emergency exit. So when the radio receives sorry, decoder 2 will be used to decode emergency. Now, this radio doesn't have a display, so we can't display emergency. We can't display the digits for emergency. All we can do is we can program this radio to have emergency exit. So when the radio receives 04002, the radio will exit emergency. Emergency exit. Decoder number 3. Stun. 05002. When the radio receives 05002, it should stun. Decoder 4, unstun. 00002. When the radio receives that, it should unstun. Decoder number 5. This is used to decode the AUTAC knowledge. So when the radio receives 6 zeros, it should regard that as being an acknowledge. So what we are saying here is that in effect, because this radio doesn't have a display, we can't decode and display caller ID. We don't need a decoder, for example, to decode and display PTT-ID. We don't need a decoder to display an incoming emergency. So this radio will not be able to see who has pressed the emergency button, but this radio will be able to send an emergency. So we only need 5 decoders. Let's look at AUTAC knowledge. Again, AUTAC knowledge will send the acknowledged telegram, and the acknowledged telegram is telegram 4. And it should do that when the channel is free. Let's look at the buttons. In terms of the buttons, per personality, PTT, whenever the radio presses PTT, the user presses PTT, it should send telegram 1. Call 1 should send telegram 2. Then, because we have 5 decoders, we need to enable them in the personality. Squelch, we can have a tone squelch. Auto reset mode, carrier independent, although that's entirely up to you. Then, per radio, button definitions. The button at the top here we need to set to emergency. The button on the side here is already set as call 1, so call 1 will send telegram 1. Alerts, miscellaneous, signaling definition, menu items not available, RF I'm not bothered about, emergency I need to come and change. Emergency squelch, we said that it should be carrier squelch. The on-off switch should be disabled. When the radio goes into emergency mode, it should send telegram 3. Okay, emergency microphone gain, debounce time, all of those things are okay. GPIO lines, we can't use. Contact list, we can't use. Status, we can't use. Configuration bytes, leave that alone. So there you have the configuration of the GP340. And what have we put into the GP340? Well, we've put in PTT-ID. Whenever the radio presses PTT, whenever the user presses PTT, it will send the PTT-ID. We've programmed the radio for selective call, and the radio can make a selective call to one fixed number, although you can add more by using up of the other buttons. We've programmed the radio for emergency in code. So when the user of this radio presses the emergency button, it will send the emergency sequence. We've programmed the radio for stun and unstun. So the radio will stun when it receives 05001, and it will unstun when it receives 06001, will unstun. We've done AUTAC knowledge, so the radio will send an AUTAC knowledge when it receives stun or unstun. Oh, that reminds me. Just make sure. Yeah, I didn't do it. Okay, so stun, unstun, you need to put in acknowledge. Okay, very important. So we've put all of this information now into the radio, and the radio is now ready to be programmed. So even though it's a GP340, you can still use all of these features we've been talking about in the training. Let me save the file. So I'll call it example using GP340. Save the file on the hard disk, and there you are.